What did I say to piss you off this time? Baby!
Who is the Negro in your neighborhood? In your neighborhood? In your neighborhood, I say, who is the Negro in your neighborhood when you're running from his ass each day?
Black people don't hope, we wish.
Something that crazy could only come from you.
Right now you live in belief. You want to believe things. Belief is ignorance. Right knowledge is to know. Understand that? Belief is ignorance because belief is the acceptance of things that you do not know. And every one of your prayers end with, Amen.
Let me hear you say amen. Oh, let me hear you say amen.
Amen, which is the ancient Egyptian god, Amun, and the rock was the sun in us as the original people of the sun. And we roamed the earth millions of years, 17,250,000 years exact, before Adam was created 49,000 years ago. Now, we don't know good people from bad. We don't know good food from bad. We don't know good music from bad. We don't know anything, and we were the ones who knew everything. And so they put us under a spell. What kind of spell? The spell of ghost worship. You understand? Ghost worship. And they said gospel. Ghost spell. All you know is what they told you, and you have belief in what they told you. When we were in our right state, state of Elohim, we didn't have beliefs. We knew, because we were the gods that everybody worshiped. They made us hate the rising of the sun by telling us, make sure you don't make fudge while the sun is rising. That's because we were sun people. People trying to get away from the sun made us start hating the sun. How'd they make you hate your hair? No, by telling you to pick cotton. The moment we stop comping our hair and cuffing our hair and putting our feet on the grass again, things are going to start opening. We lost our eye and our light is dim.
Whoa. Yes, sir, that's right. From New York to Jamaica to Cali, Japan to Algeria to Paris, France to Norway, Doma Doma, Poly, Vuzulu. Live from Ground Zero, it's the fastest 30 minutes on air. That's right, babies. Your show, your radio show, Bust That Ass Radio, 83.17 FM mix. And of course, you know the X stands for You Never Saw Me Coming When You Never Saw I Was At Off Dumbass. Your black Lenny Bruce on the loose, who's better than that balding mini me, two pump chump of a boyfriend. And yes, I run rings around that flat ass like Saturn, so chest my beer. That's right. And if I say anything to offend you, then you know I'm doing my motherfucking job, because you have the option to turn me off when I keep turning you on again and again and again, like a 2-foot midget with a 14-inch dick, and his name is Long Dong Silver. Cash ass. That's right, bitches. Y'all know how I start this shit with LA racist entitlement. And we go with the first question of the day, because I got you all in check like that. Question: do animals show how sloppy a motherfucker is when it comes to burying the results of a failure more often than we as humans find ourselves picking up a warm and steamy boulder of shit when we lie in the face of the public served? Or how does the overseer for Christ take the crumbs from the child that's starving for justice and feed it to the animals at the begging of the question, at the beginning of the question? You be the fucking judge, all right? I spy, stick him in the eye, who ain't ready, say I. Well, for one thing, saying I told you so wouldn't even color the picture of the goddamn day. Y'all remember the OIS, you know, the officer involved shooting of Jose de la Trinidad, right? Well, he was quote unquote standing his ground before a hail of bullets X'd his ass, and the police report said as much. So what happened to the dash cam report? How come it's not in the police report, or was it turned off for this special execution? Hate to break it to you, but, you know, do the motherfucking pigs think their quote-unquote life and death struggle with crime is isolated in a crowded neighborhood? Check it. 18-year-old Estefani knew what she saw and could never forget it. Her account contradicts the Los Angeles Police County's Department deputy's statement that they fired only after Jose de la Trinidad, an unarmed 36-year-old father of two, seemed to reach, okay, and the opportune word here is seemed to reach for his waistband. She saw the contrary, that the victim was standing with his hands and on his head when deputies shot and killed him. Now, like most fuck-ups, Operation quote-unquote cover that ass becomes the secondary procedure when the pigs canvass the area for witnesses in hopes to change their story so no witnesses can be called to court to testify against them. The use of intimidation and arrogance is the only moniker the pigs have when they try to, quote unquote, take care of their own. You know where I'm going with this, right? What the fuck? Alright? As many of you know, this is SOP, which stands for Standard Operating Procedure, to a dark code of deception. When fear and inexperience is behind the gun, a first kill is, you know, something to look forward to. The mentality of a killer cop is to fantasize about how they're going to react to seeing the bad guy fall, even if they've nothing to do with the fucking crime at all, but have the goddamn nerve to say, "I thought I saw a booty tap." Like the fucking military, every recruit coming in is expected to perform at a certain level of duress. Upon graduation, the foremost idiots have no social training at all, and everything is a target under the scrutiny of a gun or weapon of choice. Maximum firepower for the least resistance. The hypocrisy, though, is is that lawmakers and Caliwack-ass never take responsibility for its continuity in legal murder without provocation. The shadow code of operating in plain sight without being seen is getting weaker each year as millions of people now have turned their cell phone cameras on them whenever there's injustice afloat. That's unless you're a jackass that got caught trying to steal a bait car and thinking that this is the land of opportunity is the only excuse you have, then you deserve to have your stupid ass busted. And that's stupid spelled with two O's, dumbass. Already, we're paying a state levy sales tax that becomes surplus to law enforcement, and when they roll out with the new shit every 6 months, take notice of what they'll be using to detain and kill a motherfucker. Okay, the best way to change that is to hold the state taxes in escrow and demand change in social politics concerning the way fuckface pig operates in your hood. If you don't, then don't complain when this becomes a penal state and your dumb motherfucking ass has to either have to stay or move out of Babylon. Either way, getting rid of you has been the plan since the Broken Treaty of Guadalupe. And Menso, you haven't learned no more in that instance than many of you who front having a nigga as a friend. Shit. During slavery, I mean, they used to use, black kids in Florida, 2 and 3 year old kids in Florida as gator bait. If you don't know, then maybe you need to look up the word decolorization. Better yet, look where you live and ask, is this the third world we live in? Or does illegal economic segregation allow the platitude of equality under the gun of persecution? Me? Oh, no. I don't know. But you can sure as fuck ask Jose's widow and the other thousands unjustly killed in the line of the police's duty of extermination. Oh, and the funny? Minority cops, okay? Minority cops don't get into trouble killing their own. So let me ask again. Who protects us from you? You know? Gotta think about this shit, dude. I mean, think about it. I'll be black after this.
This is called Racial Profile. It was the color of his skin that scared them. It wasn't that he was 5'6" tall. It was the color of his skin that scared them. It wasn't that he weighed 150 pounds. It was the color of his skin that scared them. It wasn't the rocket. It was the color of his skin that scared them. The wallet was never a gun. It was the color of his skin that scared them. He looked like somebody capitalism taught them to kill. Somebody oppressed. Somebody exploited. Somebody from Africa, an immigrant. Somebody whose ancestors were slaves, like 3/5 of a person. Like somebody it would take 41 bullets to kill. He looked suspicious. Like something inhuman. Something it would take 41 bullets to kill. He looked like somebody capitalism taught them to kill. It wasn't the wallet. It was the color of his skin that determined his worth. four racist cowards killed one Amadou Diallo 19 times. They should be in jail serving 41 plus 19 life sentences in consecutive order. I got it right, now tell me how I got it. I got it right, now tell me how I got it right. I got it right, now tell me how I got it right. I got it right, now tell me how I got it right. I got it right, now tell me how I got it right.
Yes, I know. It's time for my Skittle Facebook report. Oh, shit, yeah. The stuff I found on my Facebook, amazing, shocking, but true. This infamous Mr. Kenny Zulu's from straight out of nowhere. A pic post of a tag truck that says, "Don't steal, the government hates competition. Terrorists, take note, they don't like other bullies when they're selfish being the world bully." This infamousbusterflirt.com, it's a dope-ass pickup what a man's bathroom should look like. It shows three wash basins. Wash basins, okay, sexy, huh? But what accommodates the basins are three naughty sculptures of women from the waist down, bent over. One up in the pooch, okay, bent over the basins themselves. You know, they got, you know, shorts on and, you know, and leggings and shit and everything. So, ladies, if your man didn't come back to the dinner table after 30 minutes, you know, he didn't leave you. He's busy cheating on you in the bathroom with Lois, Abby, and Jennifer. What's wrong with a four-way? And finally, from Ass Buster, oh my God. I mean, she's like probably like one of the weirdest motherfuckers I ever seen in my fucking life. But then again, you know, that's her. Nika Weird AF Williams, my freaky little cancer babe out in fucking Alabama, a vid post of some chick sucking dick on the staircase in broad daylight. Bitches, shut the fuck up. Y'all nasty motherfuckers done did worse than this. Alright? That's my mama. That's how we got Glennis, yo. Holy shit, time for Black Aborka. You know where I'm going with this, babies. Okay, so Lord Obama is back in the Black House. Florida, get over it. Your 47% elefante didn't win, bitches. So why is it the only state other besides Texas that are, you know, vying to be the number one spot for killing black children? Check it. Florida's controversial, quote-unquote, stand your ground law is back under the spotlight less than a year after the killing of Trayvon Martin. Michael Dunn, 45, is being held on charges of second-degree murder for the Friday night shooting of Jordan Davis, who was 17. According to authorities, Dunn pulled into the parking lot of a Jacksonville, Florida gas station alongside the SUV where Davis and three friends, all of them African-Americans, okay, were listening to music. Dunn asked them to turn down their music, and after the apparent exchange of words with Davis, he produced a gun and fired 8 or 9 shots at the SUV. At least 2 of the bullets hit Davis, causing his death. Okay, you know where I'm going with this, right? What the fuck? Why didn't this motherfucker just, like, if he had eyeballs in his fucking head, why couldn't he just, like, you know, fucking move someplace else? If he saw the motherfuckers was hanging the fuck out, drive another direction. Alright? That's called cognizant, you dumb, fat, redneck bastard. Okay? But, you know, hey, you know, this is a time where, this time, there was no fight sequence, but this time, witnesses. But I gotta thank Jeb Bush, you know, former governor there, for being an NRA gun-toting racist redneck for the law's adoption that allows some Floridians to shoot and kill with impunity while also encouraging vigilante justice. Who the fuck is that scum? Because whoever they are, they're still killing our kids. Motherfuckers been using our babies for gator bait, so what's to stop them from mass murder or all-out war? This is where the will of the people have to be stronger than this. And recall this bullshit law. Either that or the new Black Panthers either step the fuck up and do what has to be done or shut the fuck up and dismantle. You're slow on the game you preach. Now define your actions as worth and stop the bullshit passivity. Shit, the fucking NAACP didn't do shit for Shorty who shot her abusive husband with the same credentials in that stand your ground law that are provided under the law. So if you bangers be about something, then be about revolution and stop fucking, you know, and stop fucking being like, you know, the fucking bitches that you are. All right? Really. I mean, y'all chicken shit bitches ain't shit to me. Okay? And you let another future become a disposable merit to racism? Of course you ain't shit.
And you know something? Absolutely right. Absolutely right. I'll call the police and the National Guard first thing in the morning.
That's not soon enough.
God damn, I tell you, dirty condoms. Okay, so I was checking the news out yesterday. I mean, LA is supposed to be fifth in the pretty people department, right? The beautiful people. That shit, all right? That's a fucking lie on this side of the MTA tracks, motherfuckers. Okay, I was on my way to hustle up some dope and got bumped from behind by this lady. Oh, who apologized to me from behind and shit, but when I turned around to say no worries, I was looking at a human cactus, yo. The bitch had horizontal moles on her face that are about an eighth of an inch thick. Okay, and I doubt that a truckload of Proactive could help this bitch, alright? I'm thinking nitroglycerin and maybe an ice scraper. Who knows? Alright, but later that night, you know, as I've got through my shit, you know, the cops are playing Chase the Cholo. Alright? Fucking funny. You know, when the fucking, you know, fucking ghetto bird is like got flying around at night, you know, with the searchlight on. The shit looks like roaches. Motherfuckers are scattering around at 3 a.m. Right around my fucking toilet after I forgot to flush 6 days ago.
Straight got the monkey dick, man. Sitting in the cage all day long. They do this, leave me in a pile of urine.
A secret message is coming in from cultural nepotism. Okay, never mind that our jails are full of pedophile teachers and the whatnot. Hey, for the past 6 months, there's been a lot of motherfuckers on point, right, Elmo? Elmo's gay. Tickle me fucking Elmo's gay. But when it comes to the high cost of education, well, poor folks, get ready for a shocker. In 2014, the price of a GED is going way the fuck up. Almost 40% there. You thought it was expensive. Now wait till you see how much and why. Check it. For years, the GED has offered millions of people a low cost, second chance at a high school equivalency diploma. The test is updated every decade or so, but some particularly significant changes are planned. Last year, the GED Testing Service, part of the nonprofit American Council on Education, announced that it was merging with Pearson, a for-profit British company and one of the largest educational testing companies in the world. Okay, so we're learning shit from England. Isn't that fucking great? I love that. The merger, the testing service says, would help generate the money needed to revamp the test. The new assessment will be more rigorous and aligned with Common Core Standards, CCS, a set of uniform educational standards now adopted by almost every state. Which means if you dumb motherfuckers out here don't know shit about, you know, the world itself, of course you will never get any fucking where. All right? The test will be offered only on computer and will cost more. You know where I'm going with this, right? What the fuck? In Calaracas, expect that to go up by 40% on value. The average is from $40 to $100. Not many are going to be able to afford it, and that becomes an issue of class. So go from, say, $100 to $250, and you get my thrift. But let's look at the deeper controversy. Since voter ID verification didn't work in favor of the Republican vote, what's not to stop a motherfucker from requesting a GED or high school graduate certificate to prove you're American? In Arizona, SB 1050 still allows profiling with the makeup of the Democratic House and Congress. 90% people of color and only 16 white men run the Republican side of it. Guess who smells of a cum crusty pussy here? All right. Millions of immigrants who take adult learning and English classes who graduate will be able to vote. After the last ass beating, could you blame a motherfucker for stacking a deck against a more educated group of people determined to live a better life? And this shit's coming in 2 years before the voting of another president, so be like Eazy-E. You know, be like Eazy-E and get yours now, nigga. Okay? Or else you can be one of two things in the now world order: a disposable cog of the military, or as they would say, most likely in the penal state, or be a part of the penal state's problem against human bankruptcy. Think about it: the military and the institution of penal, in the penal institution, both of which never saw a recession.
The Koch brothers have been incredibly secretive.
This is a phenomenal success in my judgment.
What you have is this organization that has chapters in 34 states. They hold rallies. They bust people into these rallies. Politicians' feet to the fire on legislation they want to have passed. Not only do they force politicians to do what they want, but they also have a very strong libertarian agenda, which is against the Department of Education, against public education in general, and affects elections and policies at all levels of government, at congressional elections, our senatorial elections, all the way down to local school boards, as we've seen in North Carolina.
Yes, and we've come to the butt end of the show, and the only way to put a perspective on that which gives you a gas face, you gotta take both your thumbs and pry open that vertical mouthpiece and look that brown eye straight in the eye and pull the trigger on that person, place, or thing that's causing the madness and strife in your life. And on the 1, 2, 3, and a mighty woosah, just breathe in and stab that cabin as we count. And a 1, and a 2, and a 3, and a mighty woosah, motherfuckers. Asshole of the day. Yes. When the crack in the doorway to temptation is but a sliver, many take a split-second decision on the opportunity. Hence, the cracker invasion of Turtle Island, now known as America. Thus, greed, like money, has no emotional base nor regards to the color of one's skin. Ulterior motives are best rendered before capture, but in this case, the stupid fat bitch just couldn't stop. Check it. A federal judge ordered prison and fines for Kende Durke, 59, a former Democratic campaign treasurer, for stealing more than $7 million from candidates across the state, including U.S. Senator Dianne Feinstein. No wonder I couldn't get any dough from the Obama campaign out of this cash nepotistic state of denial. Federal court documents indicate Durke used and pilfered campaign cash to pay bills and created a sort of Ponzi scheme that allowed her to fund campaigns with money raised by 80 different candidates and clients. Reps like Linda Sanchez, Democratic Cerritos, Laura Richardson, Democrat of Long Beach, along with Long Beach Mayor Bob Foster and the city council members, Suja Lowenthal and Patrick O'Donnell, Pasadena City Councilman Chris Holden, and Assemblyman Roger Hernandez, Democratic West Covina. And these were just some of her clients. Even Los Angeles political consultant John Shulman, who has estimated in lawsuits that he lost $1 million as a result of Durkee's actions. What the fuck? This bitch was madder than Bernie Madoff and maniacal as Donald Trump in her vision. But here where the fine line of criminal maliciousness becomes skewed. Okay, remember, time is on money. So if you're poor and defraud the government of drug money, you can damn near get the death penalty. This fucking cow posted a $200,000 bail and a plea bargain for a 14-year stint in Club Fed. Of that, only 8 years to serve? Fuck, the bitch is getting a wino time. Our prison systems are so full of naughty teachers, pedophiles, and Catholic priests that a money-hungry bitch like that deserves white justice for white-collar crime when nigga justice is interment for thug life. And you mean to tell me if I speak out about the injustices of this vainglorious legal system that allows death for our youth and the enslavement of black men in prison, which, by the way, there are more of us incarcerated than we had in slavery since the 1500s, then it stands to reason that if we don't start killing rich folks soon, motherfuckers will not only crash the middle class to their own liking, but destroy what's left of the poverty class altogether. I mean, damn, talk about winding up a soylent byproduct in today's food supply. No wonder the FDA never checks the fucking morgue. What's even more disturbing is that bitch's hairdo. Look at that bitch's hairdo. You think after all that money she raked in, she could have did something with that bowl of chopped lettuce and ranch dressing? Just fucking tacky. Yep, Kende, not Kunta Kente, motherfucker. I robbed the rich and poor alike, Dirty Durke. You are the blistering asshole of the day.
We will be here forever. Do you understand? Forever. Forever and ever and ever and ever. We will be here forever. Do you understand that? Get what I'm saying? Forever.
This is hip-hop. Manifesting as the Blastmaster KRS-One.
Of what this music used to be.
Take a slug for the cause like Huey P. While all you fake niggas try to copy Master P.
Evolutionary, what? Evolutionary, you're legendary.
Smack them cheese while you scream your majesty.
You ain't fucking with the teacher, let me sum this up. Every time I come around, you demo niggas is running up. And I don't mind until I hear KRS is what? Then I say to myself, this cat is dumb as fuck. Or maybe he's just mad, cause he's young and he's stuck. Stuck in the hood, good, cause my guns is up. And when I blast you, it ain't gonna make no sense. I'ma tell the judge, Your Honor, it was self-defense. I'm KRS-One, this guy's a thief. The threat was in his mouth, so I shot out his teeth. You ain't funny, I'll track you at Pottery Man. You're not a rapper, you're a ranger.
Yo, that's right, babies, that's right. If you missed it, then play it again till you get it. You can say moving forward like a bitch, but you know I'm ahead of your bullshit. This has been your radio show, Shows of Bust That Ass Radio, 83.17 FMX. ADX stands for You Didn't See Me Coming When You Never Saw I Was App, all up in your ass. Steady slacking the room, boom, boom, harder than ever. Booty bubbles and dirty condoms. Music provided by Omega 7 Records, the Mothership Connection, and the Underground Music Scene. Check us out at mush777.wix.com/bust-that-ass radio. And leave it stinky, because it's all about cash ass, so see you in the street, bitches.